बाहर चले जाते हो गाइस, जब भी और कॉल चाहिए तो हाँ कितने घंटे का
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes, Miss Rima.
Perfect.
Hey everyone, is my voice clear?
Yeah, it's fine.
Yes. Hi, a very good evening to all our attendees. We'll be starting at 6:30 India Standard Time. Any questions or anything, any doubts that you have, you might write it in the chat window. We'll take it from there.
Hello everyone, we'll be starting in 5 minutes. Till that time, if you have any queries regarding legal research, please feel free to write it in the chat window.
Hi, Soumya. Hi, Abhay. Hi, Mishri. How are you?
Very good.
Excellent. So, yeah, I know we have like a minute before proper kickoff time. So let's give folks a few seconds to find the dial-in link, and then we can get started. Quite excited about this session.
Right. Very much.
So then maybe let's kick things off. So hi, everyone. My name is Rohan, and I am the founder of a platform called Law Ninjas, which can be found at lawninjas.co or CO. And essentially, it's a leading global platform for lawyers and law students around the world. And we organize free weekly webinars, just like this one, for students and lawyers to be able to dial into and learn about things that you don't necessarily get to learn at law school, or you do, but not in as much detail. And so we've been running workshops for quite a number of months now. And I'm really, really excited about today's session because we're collaborating with our friends at Manupatra. And the topic for today is a guide to legal research. So I remember when I was back at university, I had to learn about legal research, and it wasn't the most exciting topic, but I think it was probably one of the most important ones. And it's something that I think, everyone, regardless of what stage of your career that you're at, or where you work, whether it's at a law firm or in-house, or whether you're still at uni or even if you're a professor, you need to know a little bit about legal research. So I'm very excited about this session. I'm very, very keen to learn a bit more about legal research from our two speakers today, who are Soumya and Abhay from Manupatra. And I will let them introduce themselves and sort of take things forward. But I also wanted to introduce my co-host, who is Mishri. And so Mishri is going to take the reins from now. And so if you have any questions anytime, please do type them in the chat, and then we can address them as we go, or definitely when we have time at the end. So thank you so much. And over to you, Mishri.
All right. Thank you so much, Rohan. That was really sweet. And I am incredibly excited too. Although I have to admit, I'm very intimidated because I'm the least qualified person among the four people who are here. So I have to admit that this is a little nerve-wracking for me. But I'm really excited. Legal research, as somebody who's in my fifth year in law school, legal research has been an extremely important part of our internships, of our lives as law students. And great to have this platform to discuss, to ask questions, and to figure out what really works, what doesn't. I'm really grateful to the Manupatra team. Again, like Rohan said, we're going to let you introduce yourselves, but maybe we can just start with that. But while you do that, I'm just going to take a small, I'm going to ask all the attendees that, because Law Ninjas is such a global platform, and more than a platform, the word Rohan uses for it is community. And one of the things that we would try to propagate in this webinar is that feeling of, you know, being in a community. So I'm going to ask everybody who's part of this Zoom call to introduce themselves on the chat box. Tell us where you're from, tell us what you're doing, tell us which field of law you're practicing, tell us what year of college you're in. We really want to know, and feel free to use this to connect with each other and, you know, form connections that may prove helpful later. So while Soumya and Abhay introduce themselves, I would request everybody to do that. Awesome.
Soumya, I think you should go first.
Okay, sure. Thank you so much. So hi, everyone. I'm Soumya. I work with Manupatra as their marketing and corporate communications lead. I've been with them for a year. And in the last 1 year with the pandemic and, you know, everything kind of shifting indoors, we being away from our colleges, from our access to, you know, college access to research, access to our peer groups in a way who really contributed to our research. So we could sense that in our audience and in our users, there was that gap. So we have made sure that all the, you know, extremely tech powered features that we have on Manupatra that really make, you know, research easy for you. So we have tried to make as many, sessions about it, as many posts about it, put as much information as we can and as much knowledge as we can about legal research out there, especially for the current first year and second year, even the third year, which is experience or, you know, that senior guidance on how to go about legal research. So all the questions that you have, please feel free to, discuss that with us, use the Q&A box, use the chat box, and we'll answer all of it. Over to you, Abhay.
Awesome.
All right. Hi, Mishri, Rohan, thank you for having us. Mishri, you used the word intimidated, and lawyers and intimidated is...
Don't go together.
Right, perfect. So a lawyer is never intimidated. He's the one who is doing the intimidating. So, yeah. So I am basically Abhay, and I am the odd one out in this group because I'm the only one who has no experience in law in terms of degree. I have done my MBA. So luckily I've been with Manupatra for 4 years now, and I've been meeting lovely people like you from last 1 year online. Before that, I was meeting them, of course, in their offices and everything. So let me introduce my company first. That would be ideal, because Manupatra, we have been in this industry for 21 years now. We are the pioneers in the online legal space. So we were the first one who thought, you know, internet is going to be a big thing, and people are going to use it for research, especially lawyers. So over the years, the focus has been on technology. So we see ourselves as a technology company in publishing industry. So a lot of visualization tools, artificial intelligence, natural language processing. The idea, like in the back background, the talks are on that only. Like, what is the new feature that is coming up? What is the new technology that we are introducing? So that is what we have known for, and that is what has sustained us in this industry, because it's a graveyard for new people who are entering, because very difficult to enter, yes. Very difficult to have that credibility. So that is about Manupatra. So with that, I'll give the mic to a very excited Mishri and to take this forward. Okay.
Yeah, I think the word you used was graveyard, which which really did make me laugh. Yeah. All right. So as we start talking, we are going to the basic outline of this session is we are going to talk about ways in which I can see the chat box is filled with law students from all over the country and actually all over the world. And we're going to talk about ways you can use this technology platform that is available to the best of its ability. You can optimize your use. You can reduce the time you spend in doing research. So what I'm just going to go, how I'm going to do it, and please interrupt me if I am going too fast or I'm not saying something that makes sense. But what we're going to do is I'm going to talk about my experience using platforms like Manupatra and legal research in general. And then maybe Abhay and Soumya, y'all can give me tips on how I went wrong and how we can make things better. Yeah, does that make sense?
Yeah, perfect.
Awesome. So I think one of the first times I was expected to use the platform to, you know, deliver something to a workplace superior was in my first internship. And one problem I faced was figuring out what the correct legal question is that I'm looking for. Because my senior gave me this very long story and gave me a lot of specifics. And I wasn't able to identify what exactly are the important specifics that I should be looking at and should be, you know, searching for. So how does one identify their legal question is what I'm going to start with.
Okay. So I'll take it. Okay. So this is something that in general, all law students feel in their internships, all associates feel, you know, in their initial years. And I feel after a few years, you kind of pass it on to your junior associates and your interns. You never really, you know, get like a complete angle of it, I think, you know. Because again, that is very, very true. If you have a case and if you're going to have a proposition, be it internship, be it, you know, in your real life research, it's going to be you. If it isn't, then there are already precedents and there's no point of having a case really. So how do you go about it? Okay. So again, I could show this by an example or I could just walk you through and we could go through that example later. So just giving an instance. There's a case where at the cross-examination stage, the defense wants to introduce new documents that will be used in the cross-examination. Okay, so now this is the proposition that has been given to you by your senior, by your mentor, by your lawyer, whoever. And you're supposed to research and he's already said that, see, I already have a Karnataka High Court judgment. Okay, so do not give me the first judgment, right? I want judgments from the Supreme Court. So go ahead. Find me and give. Now, as a law student, Mishri, you would relate, and everyone who has, you know, been there would relate. You're like, okay, what is the best possible combination of words that I can find that would, you know, give me an answer?
Yeah.
So what we are doing is we are doing multiple queries. I'll write it one way, two ways, three ways, and ultimately, you know, those are the five cases that are coming that are not related. Or secondly, whatever I'm finding is going against me.
Hmm.
That's the second problem every moot, every internship. When you're finding cases, you're going to find which goes against your proposition and never going to find which.
Absolutely.
Okay. So now these are the problems. How do you go about it? So I'll just run this query. It will take me 2 minutes. And I'll show you on Manupatra how you do that. Again, now this is not just confined to Manupatra. Again, we have those features that enable it. But I'm assuming that, you know, across databases also, or as you get the understanding that, okay, this is what I searched, then I go to the next step and search this, then I go to the next step and search this. You can follow that search query anywhere. Okay. So I'll just share my screen once.
Awesome.
So just this is the Manupatra website. I'll just enter login myself. Okay. So again, the first thing that you do always is go to Google. Now, Google is not made for legal research. If you type in a search query, whatever best results come have the best SEO. They're not the most relevant ones. We are way much into marketing globally, that whatever results we are getting, they won't most probably be the most relevant ones. So in Manapatra, there's an alternative to that. We have a Manu search, which is again a free text search. Now, again, go for a free text search and start with the broadest possible perspective. Okay. Here, I know that the case is about cross-examination. That's my first place where I'll start. I'll just try it, cross-examination, nothing else. No trying to figure out what possible best combination of words here. What question of flaw, what is the issue should be there, whether, you know, should I write whether in the question and all of that, that comes. Did that, I got some good amount of 269,000 something results. Now, I just need Supreme Court of India. Done. No more searching. I'll go to the filters. Supreme Court of India is selected. It will bring it down to, as you can see, 5,500 something cases. So from somewhere around 270,000, I'll go to 5,500 cases. Now I have this option of search in results. So essentially you pick the broadest category of legal research that you can. And then within that, you know, in that haystack, you'll find your needle, but you'll keep reducing the haystack.
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah. Your needle is not the focus. Reducing the haystack. So. Search and results, you know, I'll just later stage. I'll just write later stage, you know, and I'll refine the search. Now, this is called refining your search. You made your first search. You put your filter on. You'll refine search. I'll just wait for it to load. Yeah. Now, again, now this has brought me to some 1,500 results. My haystack is smaller. I can search in results again. Now, later stage, now I'll search for document. Again, there's this whole list of keywords which have been provided. So if you find, you know, whatever you're looking for in these keywords, use it. Again, if it, like when you're looking for a disposition, appeal against acquittal, evidence, appreciation of evidence, anything like that, you can use it from here. Right now, I'll just show you how you, you know, research it further, just from refining, like reducing your heat back. Okay, here I'll write document and I'll refine it again. Looking for a later stage document. And again, some 919 results. Now, what I can do is I can go on researching further, or I can see that, okay, I have 900 cases, Supreme Court cases, I can sort it out. Now, I want the most recent cases. That's, you know, always the best way to go. Keep it like that. If you can find it there, recent cases are the best, you know, you can cite. Or if not, then you can go back to it. I'll just use decision date newest. Run this search. And once I've done that, as you can see, here's excerpt and case note, two options given there. So never, you know, start by opening judgments. Once you start opening judgments, you know, you kind of get boggled by it. The length of the judgment, switching between different ways. So as you can see, it's 10th today, 3rd of June, the Supreme Court has given, you know, a judgment on similar. What I'll do now is I'll just select case note. Once I do that, I remove this, I go for case note and I enter it. I'll get the case notes, you know, depicted here. Now I can just go through it. I click.
Right.
So, yeah. Once I do that, I can just read it here. Yes, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, these are very new cases. So this is like, that came on 3rd of June. So case note is still in process. Yeah.
So as you can see, the case note comes like this, you know. Because our team needs to go through all the judgments and then they prepare this case. Now, this has everything. What judge, you know, what acts were referred, were the section that you're referred, like looking for, has it been referred here? Base layer of what are the facts, what was the disposition. Now, in this, you can just read it here, move on and see if it is relevant.
Absolutely.
Now, the most important part here was that I did not need for even a second, you know, run another query. That's the part that I didn't need to do.
That way. I think one thing that is really that came out is how different the strategy to do legal research is from normally just Googling something or even using tools like Google Scholar, etc. Legal research is a whole different ballgame because you start with something really broad and you have to, you know, manually step by step sort of reduce the pool that you're drawing from. I think that was really cool and that was really interesting. I am going to ask you more questions, but while I do that and while you go on to the next question, I'm going to ask anybody who's participating and anybody who's attending to please put any questions that they may have in the chat box. I'm going through all of them and we will then ask you and transfer that information. Awesome.
Hey. Adding to Mishri, what she was already saying, that in Google, you just have one search bar. Mm. So everything you have to write there. Okay. There's no option to refine that search. Mm. So mostly people come with that kind of mindset. So they like one, they'll enter one paragraph. Okay. This is my case. This happened, murder happened, and this happened. So the search goes here and there. So the idea is to focus on your keywords and focus more on the refining part. So that is.
Yeah, thank you, Abhay. And all right, so also recently, this was something I was talking to my friends about how I'm, you know, moderating the session. And I was asking them that as people who have been using Manupatra for so long, are there any things that you have discovered, anything you would like to ask if you could talk to anybody from the team? And one point that a friend of mine brought up was that he recently found out that a lot of the tools in Manupatra exist. Because he was using only the basic search bar and maybe a little bit of the search and search. And I'm also 100% guilty of that. Using only the basic tools that are available. And as, you know, modern lawyers, we need to be more adept with technology. So as the technology company that you are, what are some tools that you think can, you know, really optimize our use and can really make our lives, not lives easier, but our jobs easier as legal researchers?
We make your lives easier by making your job easier. So it works. So let me just jump in here to show one query where I'll show you some of the features that we have in the judgment itself. So ma'am showed you without opening a judgment, okay, what you can do, how do you refine your search. I'll show you how do you open one judgment, and once you have got that judgment, what are the different ways to go forward with that.
Okay. Yeah.
Let's go ahead. We'll use Manu search. And let me put in our pet query, which is appointment of arbitrator. Okay, perfect. Okay, so this is appointment of arbitrator. Now, the first thing, that very first thing that you need to keep in mind before opening a judgment is you want to know if it's an overrule judgment or if it's not an overrule judgment. So this is very, very important. Mm-hmm. Can't stress this enough. So in Manupatra, we have this icon, which is the red flag. Red flag, all of us are young people. Red flag is danger. Okay. Yeah. So if you know somebody is a red flag, you have to stay away from it.
Absolutely. Okay.
Right. So this is the red flag that's there. So if it's like any judgment has this red flag, that means that case is overruled. Okay. Now, immediately, the question comes in my head, where was it overruled? Okay. Which judgment? So, just click onto that flag and it will take you to the judgment which has overruled this case. Okay. Mm. So, in this case, this is Vidya Darolia versus Trading India. So, this is one thing that you have to be mindful before opening any judgment. So let's open any judgment. For argument's sake, let's open this only.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is SBP and Co. Landmark on arbitration. You can see the number of judges in this one is very high. Okay, yeah. So these are some of the, so what the features I was telling you about are on the top of any judgment. So on any Manupatra judgment, you'll find these features. So I'll go through them each. Number one is important para. Now, what important para does for you is it gives you the list of the most important paragraphs in the judgment.
Okay. Wow.
Now, right. And people ask us, who gave you that authority? How can you say that this is important and this is not important?
Hmm.
Okay. So the argument that we give is like, this is that paragraph, 38 number paragraph. This has been cited 5 times in subsequent future judgments. Okay. So these are different honorable this paragraph in their own judgment. So that means that this has something important. This is the chunk, like the main gravity of the judgment is in this paragraph. Okay. So from here, basically you are getting a list of paragraphs, which are so good that people are quoting them in their own judgments. Okay, so this saves me a lot of time. You know, you don't have to read the entire thing. If you see that important para thing there, uh-huh. you can just see like which is the paragraph which is being quoted more.
Yeah.
Right. And if you find that, you know, this is exactly what I was looking for. This paragraph is really important. Now I can read this 2019 judgment. Okay, I can click onto this one. And I can go over to the judgment and I can read this. Okay. And of course, you can read it from here also where this is being quoted. So this is how important para work. It gives you the most quoted paragraph in any judgment. Now, another very common question, like people, this is something that seniors give to the juniors. Find me where this quiz has been cited in the recently, like whichever quote has. So for that, we have an answer. So most of the times, whenever anybody asks a question, we say, like, there is an app for that. We say there is a button for that in Manupatra. So for that, we have cited in Para, which gives me the list of the entire judgments where this has been cited. So like there is this Bombay High Court judgment, which has cited our case, SBP Patel Engineering, in the 12th paragraph. Okay, so it's giving me the list of the judgments where this has been cited and the paragraph of that judgment. So if you find that this particular paragraph is relevant for you, this makes sense, you know, this is citing my case in a right context. Then again, we have given you a hyperlink here, so you can read that judgment. So you will be able to find numerous judgments which have cited your case, and that too in a click of a button. You don't have to read the entire thing, read the paragraph first, then you go to the judgment. Okay, coming to one of our very much appreciated ones, which is visualization. Now, like people like me who are like, I am thoda sa text wise disabled, so Adish. So visualization makes me a little happy. So it gives me a 20 cases which are most relevant to my case. So these are the like list of 20 cases. Now these are the cases which have cited SBP. Okay, so these came before SBP, they have cited SBP. This case might have been mentioned in SBP. So we have also given you a legend. Okay, so legend you can track, like Konkan Railway, it got overruled in this case. Okay.
Mm.
Now what happened to SBP after 2005, if you want to see that. Okay, so these are a couple of icons these are the some of the cases. You can see Rajesh Kumar has dissented with this one. So there's a red line. Okay, if there is a green line, that means that it has been affirmed in this case. Okay, so I'm getting the treatment of the cases. These two cases has also been affirmed. One is distinguished.
Mm, okay. Yeah.
So the idea is just find one judgment that's helpful for you.
Yeah.
And leave it to Manupatra. We'll give you 10 judgments that you can rely on that are like from different courts.
Mm.
One thing, again, this doesn't stop here. This is like if you click on to this one. Okay. Now, this is my center of the universe. Okay. Right. You can follow it further. Okay, so where this particular case got distinguished, relied on, referred. So this is possible in our time. I'm saying it's new lawyers. So this is only available to new lawyers. Like in earlier cases, how much of a big library you had, like how many junior clerks you had, this was not possible. This is the gift of our age where we can serve everything digitally.
Yeah.
This is one of those tools. Let me show you just one last and we can take another question.
Awesome.
We have a lot of features. I'm so sorry. Right. So this is authority timeline. Basically, this gives me all the 924 cases plotted in an XY axis. So each of these cases represent different cases. Okay. So these are all the Supreme Court cases where this has been cited. These are all the Delhi High Court cases where it has been cited. Now I want to filter this further. Okay, I want to see where this case has been relied on. I just want to see those cases. So it gives me the list of cases in Delhi High Court, Madras, where this has been relied on. Suppose sometimes what happens is researchers luck that you are finding a case that is exactly opposite what you are looking for. So on your bad days, there is another option which is dissented. Okay, so this gives me those judgments which have dissented with this case. Okay, so these are some of the Supreme Court judgments which have dissented with SBP. Okay, so yeah, those you will be able to find from here. So similarly, you will be able to categorize them like on discussed, affirmed, mentioned. So this is one of the ways through which you, even if you just find one judgment, you will be able to find numerous others. Okay, so let me stop sharing my screen.
No, firstly, I have to, before we take the next question, I have to like take a minute because I think I'm mind blown. I don't know if I was the only one who wasn't using Manupatra, right? But I genuinely didn't know about so many of these things at all. And I had no idea that, you know, legal database technology was so advanced. So I'm still taking a minute to digest what I have learned. That
no,
is
incredible. I agree. I think that was so cool, that visualization thing.
Yeah.
I would have been so helpful when I was back at uni. The only thing I was going to say, Abhay and Soumya as well, is I'm mindful that we have some attendees from Nigeria and the US and other places. Mm-hmm. So could you tell us a little bit about, you know, what other countries or what other things Manupatra covers?
So do you want to show the TOC and,
I can do that. Perfect. Okay. Thank you, Rohan sir, for pointing that out, because we... Okay. So Manupatra, we are comprehensively used. Recently, we had a session with NELCO also. It's a national institute, like different libraries. So this is for the international coverage. So Manupatra, the idea of using one portal is like you will be able to search, like if you're searching for a term like a right to privacy. Now, right to privacy is as much as a Indian issue as it's a like global issue. You need to have different like viewpoints from what does the Supreme Court of United Kingdom say, USA say. So to keep that in mind, we have a very comprehensive international database also, which covers Australia. I think Rohan is in Australia right now, so he can benefit from this one. And New Zealand, Hong Kong, Canada. So Supreme Court judgments from all these different countries are available. Say United States, it goes back, I think, from 1770s. So like some of the landmark cases from 1770s are also there. And for like England, there is International Court of Justice. So there are different cases that comes in use, International Court of Justice, different honorable senior judges are there. So that be able to see from here. Another one is English reports. So these are some of the previous cases that are very much required in terms of, you know, when you are starting law, like some judgment that was passed in 1500 something, that was very important cited. So those kind of cases that you will be able to find from here. Okay, so very comprehensive in terms of, if you are searching for a particular query, you can just select if you want to search in the Singapore court on for anything. You can select that court and you will be able to search it from here. This was the international database. We cover Commonwealth English speaking countries, US, UK, so very comprehensive.
Okay, thank you so much. That's really helpful. Back to you, Mishri.
Awesome. I think that was really helpful, and I hope that helped any of, not only the international participants, but also Indian students who want to get a more international perspective on Manupatra.
Mishri, if I could just add one thing.
Yes, please.
So as you saw that there were separate heads for, you know, maritime cases and for all the countries. So especially students who are looking at LLMs. Maritime laws are, again, a very popular choice of LLM, especially given the situation right now in the US and going forward. Europe is becoming, you know, a more favored destination for LLM. And Italy, Germany, Italy especially, a lot of students look at going there for maritime laws and LLM there. So again, everything that you find, we'll show you later how we have business policy modules and industry modules. There, we have segregated all the legal information there is subject-wise, industry-wise. So whichever is your focus industry, GST, taxation, again, separately, direct tax, indirect tax, GST. So everything is also, it's not just information there, it's also clustered in a way so that you can use it in, you know, the way you want it.
Correct.
And again, like, I understand that, you know, a lot of international students are there or students who don't use Manupatra. So, like what we are showing you right now, it's just the heads. So, you know, this is the important information that you need. Go through these heads, and when you're searching for them, keep them in mind, you know?
Yeah,
use that.
Right, perfect. I thought I just show them also when ma'am is giving the commentary. So, stop.
Brilliant. Awesome. That was really cool. All right. So moving on and going a little ahead, another question I think that I have is, sometimes when you start doing legal research and you go to Manupatra, and actually more or most often you do it because you have a legal question and you're looking for a case law, you're looking for precedent. But I often find that what is also required is that you start with statute. You start with, you know, the Bare Act, you find something there. And then when you read a Bare Act, that is often a very, it's only the skeleton, right? You also need to find notifications and amendments and rules and regulations and case laws. So given that somebody wants to understand the provision, the Bare Act, how does the research process look like then? Is it a similar strategy that someone must follow or anything different that they can do?
Right. Very good questions. You are asking such pointed questions. So perfect. Let me share my screen again and I'll just go to Bare Act. So to access Bare Act, yes, there is a different procedure that you might need to follow. So this is like this. Is the Bare Act folder. So we also cover notification circulars. Mishri also said, like, if you need any notification circular or anything from different states. Mm-hmm. So we have there for all the ministries. So like whichever ministries or like these days, health ministry or anything, they come up with different notification circulars. So let me go to Ministry of Labor and Employment. Anybody can tell me who is heading this ministry? I have no idea, but I'm just asking, like, if anybody knows. In the chat. So Ministry of Labor and Employment, you can see that these are all the notifications that I covered. And you can see like this is very frequently updated. So 7th, we have already put in like some notification might be there. Another thing that you'll get in, like if you're using a good, Manupatra has it specifically, like everything is hyperlinked. Okay, so if you are mentioned section 1 in this notification circular, so that is hyperlinked. Okay, or if any new, like different circular is mentioned, that is also hyperlinked. So the idea is that you don't have to open 5-10 different sites to find like which are the notification circulars it's talking about, which is this section. So that is available to you. Of course, the gadget copy is also there. So if you are like working in a government office or somebody asks, you know, show me the gadget copy. So this is also there. So you can also download. So coming to the question that you asked. So which was the Bare Act one? So let me go to the next one, which is the Bare Act. So start your search whenever you have a Bare Act in mind or query related to Bare Act. Go to the central one. This is the table of contents. So Bare Act's table of contents. Now, once you see that these are arranged in different manners, alphabetical, chronological, subject wise. So if I choose subject wise, if I just want to see related, all the Bare Acts related to banking at one place, all the Bare Acts related to arbitration in one place. Let me go back and choose alphabetical because I'm a simple person. Okay, so this is A to Z. All the Bare Acts are available to you in one folder here. All the central Bare Acts, you can see from here. And there are different items, that rules and regulations, pending bills. So let me come to each one of these. Say, like, let's just go to Code of Criminal Procedure. So you can see this is Code of Criminal Procedure 1973. This will be amended as per today. Okay, so however it looks, that is how it looks in this one. Okay, so any amendment that comes, we put it here and we amend in the main act. On the right hand side, we have some icons. Okay, so this is like one of those, which gives you open it in one place. So this is opening in one document. If you need it, take out a printout of this one. So lawyers have this habit of buying this Bare Act small. So if you don't want to do that, you can take out a printout from here. So this is there. And different sections are available. Anything that is being substituted by an amendment or by a notification, that is also present and that is also hyperlinked. Commentary is also there. So on any section, if you're reading that section and you want to read the commentary simultaneously, okay. So that option is also given. Like people ask, whose commentary is this? So this is pre-Ramanathan Iyer, just giving it beforehand. Somebody asked in the chat. Okay, so right. Let's go back and show you something else, which is Consumer Protection Act 1986. Recently, in 2019, it got repealed, a new act came. Okay, so we have a provision here where you will be able to compare the 1986 one with the 2019 one. Okay. So if you want to see which section became what today in 2019's Act, so that comparison is available. So again, very helpful because sometimes people just remember the section. Section 24 was there. What was 24 section? No idea. So if you want to check that, you can do that from here. Okay. Another thing is, like, this is also there. One more. Like, we have so many icons. So, okay. So this is the Parliament. Like, if any bill is pending on a particular act, we have a separate, okay. So in front of any, if you see a particular, this Parliament sign, you can see that there is a bill pending on this one. On this section also, we have mentioned this. Okay. Similarly, this will be there for like, if any act has been passed and there is like, it's still to be enforced. So that will also have this. Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect. Okay. Now one more thing, like let's, keep switching our acts, you know, so that people find it more interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is Companies Act. So Companies Act 2013.
Correct.
This we have already covered. Comparative chart, rules and regulation, everything relating to that act is there. Now, if you are somebody who uses like different languages, so Hindi, Malayalam, these kind of languages are also available.
Awesome. Okay.
Perfect. So language friendly. So this is, if you click onto the act, like the title of the act, okay, without going to these buttons, just I want to see what happens if I click on the title. So this will open like this. Okay, so this is Companies Act 2013. Now, as I was telling you that sometimes what happens is an amendment is passed, but it is not notified. Okay, so that way also, like if you're going to the court, you should know that somebody telling you or the honorable judge sir, this is not notified yet. So that will create a problem. So we have already like given you that flag there. Okay. If you want to read this particular section, you can click this one, section 3, and you can read this from here. Okay. Or if you want to read any other, say, let's say articles.
Memorandum articles.
So in articles, section 5, you can also see landmark judgments. Somebody, I saw in the chat window, somebody asked, how do we see the landmark judgments? So this is how you see, like on article 5, like what are the good judgments from Supreme Court on article 5. Similarly, you can segregate on Delhi or whichever court you want. If you are practicing in Punjab, Haryana, you probably want from that court. So that is also there. Another thing, how do you make that search? Like, to make this search on article 5, you can use this one. So open judgments on section 5. So what it will do is, it will take you to the search engine and it will be making that search through Manu, where you will be able to find Companies Act section 5 judgments. Okay. So this is one. Now what you can also do is, you can search in results. So this is the, again, Soumya ma'am have already told you, you can refine this search further. So if you're looking for anything like insolvency case or anything, so you will be able to search on that. So this is for the Bare Act folder. Mishri, just one other also I'd like to show, which is the legal search. In the legal search, we have also given you an option. So if you have a particular section in mind, say,
correct,
with my limited knowledge, I have only NI 138. And I'd like to add one more. Okay. So which is like CRPC and which is CRPC 178. So these are the two sections. I want judgments on 138 should also be there and 178 should also be there. Okay. So now if you make this search, it will give you judgments on 178 and 138 both. Okay. So let's open this. And you can see on 178 and 138, both are being used. So
yeah,
it gives you a very good result. A lot of people say that we use Google and Google is sufficient and everything. So
yeah,
nobody is tagging these kind of, like, nobody is seeing which judgment is changed that is covered. So this,
correct,
our editorial team does, they see, and it's actually on one thing more, since it's come up, so it is like these are all the acts that were used in the judgment. Now what we have done is we have created, like, these are the relevant sections. So somebody read the judgment for you and he said the judgment is on 138 and insolvency 140. Okay. So actually the judgment is on this particular section. Like, these are all the sections, these are used, but it's on 138 and section 40. Now what we have done is we have given you in legal search one relevant section search. Okay. So if you want judgments, say, make it more interesting, IPC 302 is there, na? Right? Or is it CRPC?
You're talking about murder, right?
Right, right.
Yeah, 302 IPC, yes.
Perfect. So this is IPC 302.
Yeah.
If you're looking on cases where IPC 302 was the relevant, like, that was the main section.
Yeah, yeah.
So that way, you'll be able to find cases where IPC in the relevant section. So these are some of the ways that you can tackle that act-wise search problem. So one is that you can go to the Bare Acts and you can see an entire thing about the Bare Act.
Uh-huh.
And if you want to make the judge, like, find the judgments on a particular section, legal search is something that you can go back to. Okay.
So awesome. This,
right. Perfect.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Okay, if I could just add to all that he said from a lawyer's perspective now. Now, the biggest nightmare of my entire law college was my corporate law. Why? Because every time my faculty used to read a section, then she would refer one sort of rules, then she would refer a second set of rules, then she would bring us back to that section and said, this is huge Bare Act. I still remember companies that have this huge Bare Act.
Yeah.
Similar as that. Yeah. That was the end of it. So here, when, like, again, I also did not know the all the features. Then I joined and I went through everything and I was like, why didn't I know this, like, 2 years ago? So from on a digital platform, you have all the sections. You can switch between sections.
Yeah.
You have all the rules and regulations in one place. You want to read judgments on a particular section because, again, an enterprising student wants to understand, you know, and understanding is not possible with the bare, you know, reading of the section.
Yeah.
That's why we need to go through better. Again, as Abhay sir showed, the relevant section is very important, you know,
yeah,
because that's a fault which is with databases also. You can perform a section search, but they'll show you every judgment where that section was even mentioned in passing. It does nothing for, you know, what you are looking. You're looking if that section has been discussed, if those provisions of the sections were discussed. You know, you can't find them like that.
Yeah.
So that is why that particular field is very rare. The idea, I think, at the bottom of it every time is that you make one search.
Yeah.
And you get everything that you need. You never have to go to your search bar again. And it's all seamless. Like, one leads to another to another.
Yeah.
Hyperlinked properly, you know, iconed everything. So that's the idea on how you go up.
Very cool. Awesome. That is incredibly interesting. And with everything I'm learning, I'm, you know, I feel like for the first time, I feel like doing legal research. the first time in 5 years, I feel like it. I think, you know, in the beginning, I said that one thing I really want to pick up from this session personally is what are the things that I'm doing wrong? And before we go more specifically into mistakes that people like me and students and lawyers make with a platform or a technology like Manupatra, I just want to say that I think the primary thing that we are doing wrong, and this is a realization that I've had, is get too intimidated by the technology. As lawyers, lawyers in general, you know, are people who are a little uncomfortable with technology, if I can make this generalization. A lot of my friends are extremely uncomfortable with making Excel sheets also. And
crippled is the word I like.
Crippled, exactly.
Tech crippled completely.
Tech crippled, and we're very proud of the fact that we're technologically handicapped. And I'm also guilty of this. I'm not saying that I'm an exception. But I think one thing that as a community we need to start doing is be less intimidated by technology, because the possibilities are endless. I mean, if you're able to research better, you're able to give better arguments, and eventually you get better policy. So this is really cool. So yes, so going back to mistakes that students or lawyers or young associates or researchers in general make with using platforms in general and Manupatra more specifically, we would love to talk about that.
Okay, so I'll take that. See, in terms of mistakes, I think the first one is that when you look at legal research and you're so intimidated by it, and this I feel that in India, there's a lot of this and you need to reduce it on some level, is that your legal research cannot just be for your projects, for your classes, and for your internships, okay? As a law student, you're supposed to, for every profession, you know, doctors serve the community. Like even accountants, banking people, they are supporting the economy. As lawyers, we are supposed to support policy development in a way. We're supposed to bring, you know, people justice. How do you go about it? By being very good at what you're studying. And that I feel that even after 5 years of study, 55 subjects down the line, we know, like a lot of times you have to refer back to every section.
Absolutely.
Every senior lawyer carries that handbook because we don't know the sections, okay? So the first thing is to realize that legal research is something that I need to embrace because it's integral. It's integral. Mm. The second step is that, you know, technology, as we just showed, Manupatra in India at least, and even abroad, a lot of the features I remember me and Abhesa did that USM symposium. And, you know, these features don't exist, but these exist with us. They are going to come up even more and more, you know, in the coming years. We are advancing every single day. Today, we introduced the order time, right, in our judgments. So from that one tab, you can see all the previous orders that have been cases like MC Mehta, or, you know, again, every case would go from an appellate level to the Supreme Court.
Absolutely.
Every single case. For, you know, there are different citations, there are different courts. You cannot just trace back the history. How do you do that? We have that one tab. Abhesa, I will show you that in some time. And in that one straight timeline format, we have all the orders. We have the case name, we have the advocate name, the order is hyperlinked. Click on it, read it, download it, do all of that. So, now, my point is that all this technology is available, is going to be available more and more in the future.
Yeah.
And that is where we are at. Virtual court hearings have become the norm. Now, they will be more, especially given the access of justice. Zoom meetings have become the norm. Now, you wouldn't be, you know, willing to travel to another city for a 3-hour seminar. No. You know, that's too much of expense, effort, resources. You would prefer these kinds of conversations. Everything is technology. Plus, it gives you better results. Now, these kind of results, just a simple thing, the brief facts that he showed. Or, you know, whether a bill is there pending in the parliament, which sections have been notified. No legal book covers that, especially not in real time.
Absolutely.
You would have to go through news stories, and news stories, as we know, again, not to, you know, it's not their fault.
Yeah.
Media, more and more, be it Live Law, be it, you know, all the major houses have become paid and subscribed. One, that is the problem there. You have a limitation on the number of articles you can see. Plus, the information that is carried is not, you know, really up to the mark or easy to comprehend.
Yeah.
So if you're just getting it in one place listed, hyperlink, it does not get better than that. And that idea is that it is available to you. Almost all, you know, major colleges in India have one about. That was the entire purpose of doing all these events. You know, these are free of charge events. We do so many webinars. We do so many training sessions. What is the objective of you spending your hour, me spending all the, everyone who has, you know, so kindly taken out their time and invested here? We want to learn more. So this is the technology that we are providing. We are walking you through how do you go about it. Anything that you miss, we make regular posts on our social media, detailed. We have everything on our website, you know, in the form of a training manual that you can browse. All these live demos are in the form of short snippet videos on our YouTube. So everything is at your fingertips now. Just, you know, it's just time to dive in and, you know, work through it.
Yeah. Brilliant.
So, okay, so I took a lot of time coming back to what the mistakes are. As Abhesa showed, never cite an overrule judgment. And again, in lawyer life and otherwise, always look for red flags. Wherever there's a red flag there, just, you're not, like, that does not serve you anything. So don't go there. Again, we have different kind of flags. We also have a yellow flag because, again, a lot of time judgments are not completely overruled. They are partially overruled. You know? So for that, we have a yellow flag. Now, these flags are just not that a red flag. Click on it, it will show you where the judgment was overruled. So what's your better option? You go again directly there from the judgment, see all the features, move on. That's one mistake. Second mistake with legal research, again, is to, you know, start with directly copy-pasting the proposition.
Mm.
You can do that as well. It's a free text search. That's why, you know, especially for kids just starting out in research and all of that, you can write,
yeah,
obviously. But again, start from a broader perspective. Just run one search and get everything through the refined search button. So don't use the entire proposition. Use the words. You know, it goes easy on you. It goes easy on your brain. You're not daunted, yeah, by the multiple windows.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, you can follow that in your sequence. When it comes to, I feel a lot of students are here. So research papers, blogs, articles, whatever you're writing. You know, the common trend is that I'll Google that. There are already 5 blogs on that. I'll just collate them.
Hmm.
And I'm not kidding you, the number of amount of plagiarized content, na, in top websites at time, I'm like, how is, yeah, this even possible? But it's literally the same content.
Yeah, yeah.
So it does not serve you. So rather, yeah, than when you're writing a research paper, trust, yeah, yourself.
Yeah.
Run a legal research and, correct, then write them.
Yeah.
You know, these would be the 3-4 things I feel that, you know, everyone should keep.
Yeah. I think what also happens when you use a platform that is as objective and neutral as Manupatra compared to something like Google, which has opinions and it has articles and it has sensationalized versions of cases, is that you get to form your own opinion before, mm-hmm, you get color, like your opinion gets colored by an external article or a media page you really like or an author you really like. So I think that is another important reason that first you should use like a neutral medium, a medium that is just core information, core supply of, yes, information, and then transfer to the rest.
100%.
Awesome. Anything else you all would like to add? We are moving towards the close of our session. So anything you all think is relevant to add, guys, you all can continue to put in your questions. Even if we can't answer them in this session, we will bully Abhay and Soumya into answering them later. So please...
Just show the highlight and sticky note feature, because someone asked in Q&A that can they have notes on Manupatra? Like, can they save notes on Manupatra?
Okay.
So right. If you could just show that. Awesome. Any of that.
Yeah.
I'll just do that. Just sharing my screen.
Yeah.
Okay, not really. I'll just show you like how you do it, and when you have like access to Manupatra, you can just go ahead and do it by yourself. Okay, so because like one is, how do you make notes? Like this is, you can leave a note on any judgment. So if you read this judgment in future, you found a paragraph which is important, so you can just create one note here. And any time in the future, your junior is opening the judgment, your,
yeah,
senior in that judgment, they'll find that note, and one, he'll know that you have read this judgment. Number two is he'll find this paragraph also that you have left for him, so which is again important. So how do you do that? We have this option available, My Notepad. You can create more notes from there. I'll also share our YouTube videos, so from there also you'll be able to share. One thing else ma'am asked, how do you create sticky notes, like how do you highlight things? Now again, this is very, this was something like this we used to show in passing in the pre-pandemic times, if anybody can remember those times. Now, like due to the online hearing and everything, people are asking us for this feature. This is, how do you highlight and how do you show? Because,
yeah,
we are doing right now, people are sharing their screen with the honorable.
Exactly.
Right.
Yeah.
And if they want to get a point across to the honorable judge,
yeah,
and so they want to highlight a particular point or something is already highlighted, that makes a good impression.
Yeah.
So this is what they are doing, and they can also leave a comment. So if they want to add a comment, something here, so that you can do, you can take out a printout with or without comment. So both are available.
Okay. Awesome.
So all the loyal love for you know, post-its and pads and those diaries with multiple,
yeah,
post-its that, yeah, we need to carry,
yeah,
right,
we don't have access to it anymore, and we don't have access to stationery shops to get them all. So
yeah,
everything you can do online,
everything, yeah, absolutely,
yeah, just share that with your mood mates, whatever, do it, just,
yeah. Really, you know, a virtual page mark, a virtual sticky note, everything is available. That's awesome.
Exactly.
Yeah. Avoid red flags and everything you can.
Avoid red flags. That is my favorite thing from this session. All right. So as we start moving towards the close, again, I'm going to ask everybody any pending questions, any pending doubts. Yeah. Feel free to put them in. Yes. Sorry.
There's one question that I would just answer. So is it possible to find research done and published by other scholars? So, you know, essentially, we cover articles, we cover ebooks. All of that is covered on Manupatra. So Abhisar is answering questions, I believe. Mm-hmm. I'll show that to you on the TOC. Again, Manupatra also publishes, articles every week from students. So if you're interested in submitting some research to us that you want published, please feel free to do it on articles@manupatra.com. Again, as you can see on the left side, articles, you can select that and you would find all the articles that have been recently published. Again, if you just want to search in articles, just select this checkbox here and go and do your manu search. Okay. So then your results would only have the articles that you're looking for. Okay. So that is something that we cover, and this is how you can find it. Okay.
Awesome. All right. So one thing that I definitely want to do before we close and before people start leaving is we have picked up so much cool information today about Manupatra, and it would be awesome if everybody can put in anything that they picked up and they would specifically remember in the chat box, maybe, so if anybody else missed that, it would be like a good refresher and be a good indication to Abhay Soumya about the things that really caught on and made a difference. I think that's a great way to close. And before, another thing I would like to say before we close is that a couple of people have asked about the recording of this session and the whatever they have learned. So there are two things. One, the Law Ninjas platform will be sending you a downloadable PDF, right? Am I right, Rohan, when I say that?
Yeah, as long as I get a downloadable PDF.
That's all with us. So do you want me to share that right now in the chat? Or
sure, like, I think I'll that just might be it. Easier.
Awesome. Yeah. Okay. Awesome. So we're going to share it right now. Thank you, Parni. Yes, she said visualization of cases, avoid red flags. That is a very good session. I wish all my friends who are attending this, especially my girlfriends, they're all paying attention to this. Awesome. I think another thing about Law Ninjas, just before we close, the recording will be available on Law Ninjas for sure. Apart from this, all of the sessions that Law Ninjas does, which are some very cool sessions on some really cool topics that are relevant to lawyers, are also available on the portal. And they also do, like Rohan said in the very beginning, we also do sessions every week that are completely free and are attended by people all over the world. So this is a great place to network. This is a great place to feel at home and discuss important legal topics. So we hope that you will join the community, become a part of this. And I'll just hand it over to Rohan to close.
Yeah, no, thank you so much, Soumya, Abe. That was amazing. You know, the visualization I thought was really cool. A lot of it was stuff I didn't even know existed. So I'm very, very happy that this session was so informative and so engaging for everybody involved. And I also want to say a huge thank you to Mishri. I think the energy and the enthusiasm that you showed was just unparalleled. So thank you so much, Mishri, as well.
Thank you.
If any of the attendees today, if you have any questions, if you have any kind of queries or concerns that, weren't addressed properly, just let us know. You can find Soumya, Abe, Mishri, or me on LinkedIn, or I'm sure, we're going to add you to our distribution list. So you'll get an email from us soon at some point as well. So again, just wanted to close out by saying thank you so much to the attendees and to our speakers and to the amazing host today. We'll see you guys very, very soon at Manupatra's workshops as well as Law Ninja's workshops, which are going to be happening every week from now on. So thank you.
Great. Thank you, Rohan. Thank you, Mishri. Mishri, you have been great. You are just
thank you. Thank you.
You're an amazing listener. So it's like really
we discussed a lot of things.
Thank you. Thank you so much. That is incredibly encouraging.
Yeah, I've shared the link for the PDF. So everyone who wants to download, it's in the chat. It's a ready link. Just you can download it directly from there. And I hope that you retain the information that you use in it.
Awesome. Right. All right. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you,
everybody.
This was great fun.
Bye-bye.
Okay.
Bye.